Okay, so at the end of the last video, after we wrapped up this really amazing and really very different material, and it is a little bit crazy, I'll be the first to admit, I realized that I did not actually give you a full-blown picture of what my material graph looked like, so I wanted to do that really quick. And to really show that off, I'm going to reshape my UI for just a moment. Let's expose the tab to the graph window by clicking, if you didn't see that, on the little tiny orange triangle in the upper left corner. And then I'm just going to break off the graph window, and we'll just float it. So I just got to find an area where it's not trying to dock. So right about there. And then I'll double click to make that nice and big. And then here's the network in total, right? So obviously, taking a look at it from this distance is probably only somewhat helpful depending on the size of your screen. But I want you to see the whole thing, and then we'll zoom in and go section by section. So first off, you'll notice that I've got a single texture coordinate node that is kind of branching out to different locations along the network. Now let's take a look at just the color section. So you can see how we have the red being multiplied by the wood to kind of get that grainy red. And then we take the value, the result of that, and we linear interpolate that with just the bare wood itself so that we have bare wood and then some red tiles that look like they're painted wood. Then we do the same thing again. We multiply the wood grain by blue, and then we take the result of our first lerp, and then we linear interpolate that with the blue version. So we have also some blue tiles. We multiply all of that by our little tile texture to get some darkening in between. So I just want you to see that part of the network. Roughness was really straightforward. We just did a lerp that was based off of the alpha channel from the wood, and that's going between. You can actually see it previewed right here in the viewport. A is 0.8 and B is 0.3, so it's a lot smoother as you get out of the wood grain. Then for metallic, we just left that at 0, so it's not a metallic surface at all. Emissive, we're taking the red channel, which is again just the area of gaps between the tiles. We ran that through a contrast operation. And then we multiplied that by orange, and then we multiplied that by 100 at first. I just pulled it down to 50 just a second ago because it was just a little bit too bright for the preview window, and we plugged that into emissive. Then finally, for the normal map section, we took our original wood grain normal, and we combined it with the tile normal map. And we did that by first masking out the red and green channels from the second normal map, and then appending a value of 0 to those. So basically, we now have an RGB color where blue is empty. Blue is just a value of 0. There's no blue information. Then we add the results of those two together so that we end up with a final normal map that is actually both of those things together, and we plug that into normal. So again, this is a really short video. It's just for those who wanted to be able to recreate that material that I made over the last couple of videos but needed to see the graph up close. That will close things off for this video. Thanks a lot.